Welcome to ShavedApe's Pearls of Wisdom. Yes, hello guys, this is ShavedApe, and this is a new series that I hope will help you to improve your FPS gaming. I'd like to think a lot of these tips will carry over into most FPS games. So this series is aimed at helping you no matter what the game, okay? I love FPS games, and most of my spare time is spent playing them, you know. Specifically at the moment, I'm playing a lot of Medal of Honor Warfighter. For the next few episodes at least in this series, I'll probably be playing a lot of Medal of Honor. But anything I do in that game can probably be carried over into other FPS games as well. So this is tips that can be used in most first-person shooters. Now then, on with the show. This video is all about getting a maximum FPS in your chosen game, okay? That's frames per second, for those that don't know. And the reason we want to do this is to get the smoothest gameplay possible. Competitive gamers, and I used to be one, don't really care too much about how good a game looks. For a single player, sure, go and shove everything up to ultra, make it look great. Why not, okay? But for multiplayer, the smoother the gameplay, the easier it's going to be to see your target. And that ultimately is the goal here, isn't it? Regardless of playing the objective, we want to be able to shoot the guy as quickly as possible before he sees us, ideally. Okay. Now, if you want to be really competitive, you can lower your resolution in your game. You'll get more bang for your buck FPS-wise. But you're potentially going to have a larger area to aim at, so therefore you're going to move your mouse a little bit less, and therefore maybe make the hitbox feel a little more accurate because you're having to move around less. Okay, I know competitive gamers that play as low as 1024/768. So there you go. That's really low resolution, but it works, and my God, their aim is amazing. Okay. I personally play at 1920x1080, tried lower resolutions, couldn't aim for toffee, so I'll stick with my current resolution of 1920. Now I do use a different, or I use an FOV, of course, a field of view, and mine is set around 80 in most of my games. No idea why, it just happens to feel the most comfortable for me. And changing your FOV can significantly affect your mouse sensitivity, so if you're going to change it, please do keep that in mind. FOV is quite personal. Some like it up at say 90, while others prefer down at 70. And I'm not going to try and tell you which you should use, because as I say, it's personal. What I will say is the greater the FOV, the smaller the target will be, and the further away it might look, okay? And you tend to get a more fisheye sort of look on things, okay? And that's not great, okay? So, as you can see, my settings are set at custom, and I have certain settings that are high and certain ones that are not that low. I'm running for those that are interested, a Sapphire HD 7970 GHz edition, 3GB GPU. And to answer the questions, why pay so much for a card and then lower so many settings? The answer is simple: maximum FPS equals smoothest gameplay. So, as you can see, not everything's set to low. I did experiment with my card to see which settings in the game hit my FPS the most and which didn't. One setting that I tried to keep as high as possible, as you can probably see, is the mesh setting. Okay. Having looked it up, I believe that it helps objects render faster in-game, and I feel, but feel free to correct me on that one if I'm wrong in the comments. I didn't go with Ultra because the FPS hit versus the benefit just wasn't really worth it. Anything else, as I say, really came down to how it affected my FPS to a degree. And that is to say, while I want nice textures, I don't really care about shadows. And the reason for that, well, it's fairly simple. A nice shadow may look good under that tree over there, but what if someone is lay there, hiding in that shadow, and I can't see him because of the shadow? Now, if I can reduce the shadow or even get rid of it, then I'm going to see him easier, so I'm going to be able to shoot him quicker. Yeah? So with all that said, you have to find what's best for you, and there are always more things you can tweak. that's up to you to decide what works for you. Okay, maybe playing with for Nvidia users, for example, or Nvidia or Nvidia, whatever the, however you say it, digital Vibrance. I know you can play around with that, and that can change the colors a little bit. ATI users, I believe, well, I know because I've got one, increasing the saturation does a similar sort of thing that to digital Vibrance, and it sort of makes the colors a little bit more, well, vibrant. And therefore can maybe make it a bit easier to see the guy that's standing behind the tree or whatever. There are no set rules here though, so it is really up to you to try and figure out what's best for you. Okay, but as I say, you want to try and go for smooth as possible. Okay, but hopefully this gives you an insight into why some people just seem to see you quicker than others. Okay, now then, before I end the video, I want to just point out that, that I don't use vertical sync. Okay, never have, never will. I just don't use it, and I never will. Okay, and the reason for that is most competitive gamers don't use it either. We tend to use a FPS cap, and the reason for that is input lag. We don't want input lag. We want to get rid of that as much as possible. So there are those out there that say it doesn't exist because things have improved and technology and so on and so on. Whatever, I know that competitive gamers still favor an FPS limit over vertical sync, and those guys are the guys that have reached the top and saying it are obviously, you know, they should know whether there's input lag or not, and they still choose an FPS limit. So you decide for yourself, okay? And to do that, you're going to create a text file in the root of your game, or the install directory of your game. This applies to Medal of Honor. It can be used in BF3 as well. Chances are a lot of other games. I remember back in Call of Duty 4, for example, throwing one in a folder there. I can't remember which one, but you get the idea. Config files in FPS games go back as far as I can remember, well before, say, Medal of Honor Allied Assault, for example. So you're not doing anything wrong. This is normal practice, especially in PC gaming. You're trying to tweak the game to get the best possible game you can and to make it as comfortable for you to play as possible. I'll put the details in the description, so if you're interested, have a look in there, and hopefully you'll see the benefits of why, because I will try and explain it a little bit better there. Okay, that's it from me. I want to say a big thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and above all, I hope it helps you to improve your gameplay and experience. Please let me know if it does. I'd love to hear back from you if it does. So this is me, ShavedApe, saying until the next time, I am out of here.